Here we go, here we go. People of Earth, how are you? Good evening and welcome once again to the House Arrest Concert. This one is episode 76, coming to you live from Mount Laurel, New Jersey. With me, your host and sole performer, Bill Spence. Thanks for joining me on this kind of, oh, what's it doing? Oh, I can't see anything, it's dark now. But I think it's been kind of rainy this afternoon. But you know, any day on the green side of the dirt is a lovely day. Be watching. Thank you for joining me. And Gil Scott Heron, A Lovely Day. It's from his 1975 album, From South Africa to South Carolina. And it's kind of a grim reminder that even though in these days of widespread cooties, there were crazier things to worry about back in 1975 when he wrote this, South Africa to South Carolina. Of course, one of his big songs was Johannesburg, which lamented the state of apartheid, which was going on in South Africa. And by 1994, I think, that was the end of apartheid, and that's just remarkable that it's only 27 years ago that went away as a political thing. Nice and cold, but Gil Scott Heron, from his 1971 Pieces of Man album, came The Revolution Will Not Be Televised, and that kind of cemented him as a progenitor of hip-hop music. When he passed away in 2011, Public Enemy's Chuck D said, "We do what we do and how we do because of you." R.I.P. G.S.H. Yeah, so Gil Scott Heron. He performed this song with, of course, his partner of many years, Brian Jackson, his musical partner, on Saturday Night Live in December of 1975, as a matter of fact. I played, Janice Ian's at 17 last week, and she did that. She was one of the first performers on Saturday Night Live. He was also, a couple months later, Gil Scott Heron. Look it up. A Lovely Day. Standard from lyricist Sammy Kahn, whom you might recognize as the writer of such songs as Three Coins in a Fountain, Let It Snow, performed by Many, many people. Including Frank Sinatra. He did this song, but originally it was done by Bing Crosby. It's written by, let's see. Let me go to my notes. Johnny Burke, Jimmy Van Helsing. Anyway, the songwriter was actually discussing this song at a dinner with Bing Crosby because in 1944 this song was number one. Anyway, the writer of the song was at a dinner with Bing Crosby, and at the dinner, Crosby's kids were complaining about having to go to school the next day. He was there discussing this song that he wrote for Crosby to sing in Going My Way. Sinatra did it in 1963, by the way, but 1944. Crosby's kids were complaining about having to go to school the next day. Bing looked at son Gary, and instead of beating him up in front of a stranger, as he did in private, said, you know, if you hate to go to school, you might grow up to be a mule.
Would you like to see a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a mule? A mule is an animal with long, funny ears. He kicks up at anything he hears. His back is brawny and his brain is weak. He's just plain stupid, the stubborn streak. And by the way, if you hate to go to school, you may grow up to be a mule. Oh, would you like to see a star? Carry moonbeams, hold in a jar, and be better off than you are. Or would you rather be a pig? A pig is an animal with dirt on his face. His shoes are a terrible disgrace.
Sinatra did it again in 63. And I remember when I was a kid, I don't know why I thought this is one of the crazy things I thought. Because I had heard of Cary Grant, and I thought that Cary Moonbeam was a person, and for some reason he was home in a jar. Go figure. It's just the kind of mental debilitations I had. So, the trivia today. Today is Boston Cream Pie Day. It's also iPod Day. It's also the Swallows Depart from Capistrano Day, where it's San Juan Day. And the Swallows, about this time of the year, depart San Juan Capistrano, California, the cliffs there, and go to their winter homes in Argentina, and in a place called Goya in Argentina. And then around March 19th or thereabouts, they come back up. Interesting. So that's the day. Other things that happened on this day, in 1941, the movie Dumbo was released. And in 1963, on Broadway, Barefoot in the Park debuted, Neil Simon's play, starring Robert Redford and Elizabeth Ashley. In 1983, the bombing of the Beirut Marine Barracks happened. It killed 241 U.S. soldiers, 58 French soldiers, 6 civilians. Quite a thing. 2011, if you had your TV time machine, you could go back 10 years and watch the pilot of Once Upon a Time. I do remember watching that. My cousin Kelly is a big fan of that. And I watched a few episodes of it. I was underwhelmed, but anyway. 1983, on this date, Jessica Savage, groundbreaking news anchor on KYW-TV in Philadelphia with Mort Krim and Vince Leonard. She died tragically in an accident in a canal in New Hope, Pennsylvania. Now, what else happened today? It's Johnny Carson's birthday, 1925. He was born. 1942, Michael Crichton was born, the author of course, The Andromeda Strain and Jurassic Park. 1954, Ang Lee, the director, directed Brokeback Mountain and The Life of Pi and a bunch of others. 1959, Weird Al Yankovic. And so much stuff. Look at this thing full of trivia. And I'm going to get it all, or I'm going to go home. On this day, Robert Bailey of the LA Rams in a game versus the New Orleans Saints made a 103-yard punt return, holds the record. Speaking of football, I don't normally watch college football on Saturday. I put it on in the background with the volume down while I'm researching my trivia, but man, how about that Penn State-Illinois game today? It went 9 overtimes. Of course, that 9 overtime in college is slightly different than overtimes in pro ball, but just an interesting game. And sorry about that, Penn State losing to Illinois in the 9th overtime. On this day, at the age of 82, Jay Black of Jay and the Americans passed away. So, here's a drink to him, Jay Black. In 1929 saw the founding of the Transcontinental Air Transport, which eventually became TWA Airlines, but their service across the United States from New York to Los Angeles. And it actually took 2 days and encompassed 9 flights during the day and several train legs. But that was TAT. People derided that as standing for take a train, But yeah, 1929, first transcontinental airfare was available. $532 it cost. In 1929 dollars, that's a lot of dollars. And what else? 1926, Gertrude Ederle, American swimmer, became the first woman to swim across the English Channel. And that was a Jeopardy answer on a question. When I took the Jeopardy test back in 1984, when it was first coming back on the air, did that at the Essex House Hotel in New York. That was one of the questions I got right. Gertrude Ederle, 1926. And finally, in 1992, at an airport in Colombia, a woman was detained because she had unusually large buttocks. Turns out that 1.5 pounds of heroin had been surgically implanted in those buttocks. And so they arrested her and confiscated 1.5 pounds of heroin. There you go. As the Domingos changed to the Spinners in 1961. They come from Ferndale, Michigan, a suburb of Detroit. They were known in England and Europe for some time as the Detroit Spinners or the Motown Spinners, to avoid confusion with a British group called the Spinners over there. But they're the Spinners. You gotta love them. Oh no, 7:55. Songwriter called Jerry Fuller wrote the first three hits from this band from San Diego. This one hit number two in 1968. As with freakishly many of the songs that I pick, number two is as high as they get. This one was held back from number two by the number one Hugh Masekela hit Grazing in the Grass. And let's see how this sounds. I don't know if any of this guy's hits would fly today, especially Young Girl, but this one might be okay. Lady, willpower, it's now or never. Jerry Fuller, who wrote Traveling Man, that you may recognize from Ricky Nelson. He was also a part of the Champs, did Tequila, and in the champs were also Glenn Campbell, Jim Seals and Dash Crofts, or Dash Seals and Jim Crofts. I forget who's which. Anyway, it's 8 o'clock. I've wasted enough of your time. I'm going to try to do a couple more. These guys, like, really big for a really long time. Well, not really, really big. They lamented that they came from Swindon in the UK. They said if they had come from like London or New York or Liverpool or a bigger town, they would have been much more popular. But man, I liked them. I really wasn't terribly aware of them until I heard this song on the Gilmore Girls, of all things. Let's see if I can do this justice. I probably can't. Album was produced by Todd Rundgren. So there you go. This next guy is from Tulsa, Oklahoma. He was a friend of Leon Russell's, and they used to play in bar bands in Oklahoma. But in the 60s, He moved to LA, formed a band, and named it after a truck. A bread truck. It's called Bread. This is from David Gates. This was the number one song in 1970.
Winging his eye. Well, honey, how can you care he's not me. He's not me.
Swallows depart from Capistrano Day. Weird Al's birthday. All these things. I wish you had a lovely day today. I certainly did. And appreciate you being here. Until next time, ciao, ciao.